Hey there, I'm Shauna, the Chief Creative Officer here at S. Barnes Designs. And today we're going to look at how to use Canva to optimize your images for your website, not just size-wise, but also for accessibility. So let's dive in. As you can see here on my screen, I already have Canva open. You can go to Canva or access it at canva.com. I don't get any kickbacks for recommending them because they don't have an affiliate program. It's just a really easy to use online program. Okay. So one of the things that we're going to do is we are going to create an image for a WooCommerce product. The recommended size for WooCommerce is 1000 by 1000 pixels. So we're going to come over here in the upper right hand corner and we're going to say create a design. Now, the standard, as I mentioned, or the recommended, is 1,000 by 1,000. You can use an Instagram post, and then because that's roughly 1,000, it's 1,080 by 1,080 pixels, or you can come down here and use this custom size. We're going to use custom size, and you can see that because it's one that I use on a regular basis, it's already listed in my recent sizes for Canva. But we're going to go ahead and type it in here. And we have the measurements as pixels. You can also use inches, millimeters, or centimeters. We're going to go ahead and keep it at pixels. So we're going to do 1,000 and 1,000. So 1,000 pixels wide and 1,000 pixels tall. And we're going to say create a new design. One of the reasons that you want to optimize your images for your website is if you upload your pictures from your phone or your camera, they're really big, you know, 1, 2, 3 megabytes, right? And the larger the image size, the longer it takes for the web servers to load your site, which degrades the experience that the users have when they access your website. And we don't want that. So a good rule of thumb that I tell all of my clients is your images should be no larger than 100 kilobytes in size, okay? So we're going to use something that I've already uploaded, and it's this image here that my intern, Kim Hall, drew for my family last year for our Christmas card. Now, the original size for this image is 2.97 megabytes, way too big. So we can either leave the image centered and have this white negative space, or we can click and drag the corner. If you click and drag the corner, it scales proportionally. If you use these handles on the sides, it will scale the box. And you can see that the image hides it. So it's kind of like a crop feature and scale all mixed in. You can see as I'm moving it that it tells you the height and the width as well. If you want to make sure that your image is centered, you're going to go to position and center and middle, and that aligns it to your middle of your page. So now we're going to come up here and we're going to rename it. Naming your images is one of the easiest things that you can do to make your website more accessible and help with your SEO. SEO is search engine optimization. All right, so we're going to name this image size toot Canva. Now, if this was all we wanted to do, we would come up here to share and scroll down to download, and I save it as a JPEG. Now, SVG tells you that it's best for web design and animations. However, SVG is also a file format that hackers use to put malicious code in. So if you don't know what you're doing, it's always best to err on the side of caution and use JPEG. The other thing is, for example, for WordPress sites, WordPress does not allow you to just upload SVGs into the media library because of the security vulnerability. So you have to use an additional plugin, which may or may not come with its own bloat or drawbacks. So again, if you're not really sure which one you should do, JPEG is your safest bet. And our size is 1,000 by 1,000 and 80. Now you see the gold crowns here? It's because I have the pro version. It allows me to change the size. If you have the free version, it may not allow you to change the quality. So you might be stuck at this 1 and at the 80 quality. And we're going to download. Now, if we come back over here, remember, the original image was 2.97 megabytes. Our new image that we just downloaded from Canva is 101 kilobytes. So that is right around that optimal size that we want that's not going to bog down our website. So we've optimized the image, but there's still a few more things we can do to improve the accessibility. So we're going to close that and come back into our Canva file. One of the great things that Canva has allowed is the ability to add alt text right in your image. Let's see if I can find where to do that. So rather than the whiteboard giving us the option to add that alt or the alternate text, you're going to click on your image and this set of three ellipses or the three circles here, you're going to click on that. And when you hover over it, it says more. We're going to scroll down and it's going to give us the option to do alternative text. Now, alt or alternative text is where you enter the purpose of the image. So what you want to do is you want to explain the purpose of the image in detail, but concisely. Okay, you don't want it to be 3, 4, 5, 6 sentences long. I do have a blog post about alt text that I'll link in the comments below or in the information for this video. So the alternative text for this is simply, oh, we're going to do caricatures of three adults, two dogs, and a cat in Christmas attire. Now, when you go to add this to your website, if all it is a decorative picture because you want to create some interest on your site, then it's going to be marked as decorative. And Canva has that option where we can make the selection to mark as decorative. If you're using it to add to a portfolio, then you still want the alternative text there because it's adding to the text. The text is enhanced by the image, I guess is a better way of saying that. So we're going to leave that. And actually, I'm going to add artist Kimberly Hall. And then I'm going to save. And now I'm going to go ahead and we're going to download that again. And we're going to look in our downloads. And the size hasn't changed at all. It's still 101 kilobytes. So this is the quickest and easiest way that anybody can go in and edit their images for accessibility and for size. So that way, when you go to add it to your website doesn't get bogged down because the pictures that you're uploading are 1 or 2 megabytes. And nobody wants that. Let me know in the comments if you found this helpful and what other tutorials you'd like to see. Have a great day.